Everybody, how's it going? I can't see any of you guys, but I hear you, so I know you're there. Welcome to Campus JAX. What a place, right? This is a great place. I'm so happy to be here. And thanks to all of you guys for coming. I know Thursday is not the easiest night, especially with the traffic. And so, anybody come all the way from LA? Yeah? Cool. That means a lot to me. Thanks for being here. So, how's this evening gonna go? Let's see. I don't usually do the talking at my gigs, so this is something kind of new for me, but we're gonna play some music for you guys, about an hour and a half of music, should be a good time. A handful of tunes from my recent album, Beneath the Blue, which is, I believe, on Apple Music at the moment. Thank you. Should be on Spotify soon. I think it's on YouTube as well. It's in the back of the room on CD, if you guys still have CD players. You can own a physical copy, which is always more fun. So, all right, I'd like to introduce the next tune. I'd like to bring up our first vocalist of the night, Anna Crumley. Please give it up for Anna. This is an old standard done by a zillion people, and I've always liked it, so I decided to make my own arrangement, and it's opening track on the album. Here we go. This is called I've Never Been in Love Before.
I've never been in love before. Now all at once it's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. Too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish song. Now my song is whole. So please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. I swear I've never been.
Give it up for Anna. Anna Crumley, ladies and gentlemen. Sings that tune great. Well, you'll see more of Anna later on as the night progresses. Right now, we're going to do something a little different. This is an instrumental tune. One of the first tunes I actually recorded for the album way back, I think it was over a year ago, so it's been a long time, but this is called Matchmaker. It's actually the song from Fiddler on the Roof done in a jazz waltz style instrumental. Hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you so much. Matchmaker, that's a great tune. Give it up for Nick Gomez on soprano sax too. Ian Holmquist on trumpet, of course. Alrighty, let's bring up our next vocalist. I'd like to introduce to you guys a Campus JAX veteran who has performed here many times with his own band and been happy to perform with him a few times here as well. Please welcome Luke Carlsen. So this is a tune Luke and I used to play various gigs around town. One time I came up with the idea of maybe starting slow, kind of building up and see how that goes, and also adding sort of like a country western twang to this tune. And surprisingly, it actually worked out. And then when I was looking for tunes to play on the album, I thought, hey, we should record this. So Luke agreed, and now it's on the album. This is Sentimental Journey.
We had Brian Sub in our big band at a club called Vibrato a year ago or so, and Billy D. Williams came out to see the band, and I also said that I was from South Dakota at some point during the set, and we were just about done, but he said, hey, can you do a country western song? So I looked at Brian, and I was like, you know what? He's like, he had it ready to go, so and this is the country western Sentimental Journey.
I'm going on a sentimental journey. I'm gonna put my heart at ease. I'm going on that sentimental journey to renew old memories.
I packed
my bag, got my reservation, spent each dime I could afford, like a child in wild anticipation. I long to hear that all aboard. Seven, that's the time we leave at seven. I'll be waiting up for heaven, counting every mile. The railroad track that takes me back. I never knew my heart could be so yearning. Why did I decide to roam? I'm going on that sentimental journey.
CLEMENS on the piano.
Back. I never knew my heart could be so yearning. Why did I decide to roam? I'm going on that sentimental journey.
I think we're gonna keep Luke around for one more tune. Luke Carlsen, everybody. This is an old arrangement of mine that I used to play back in my Cal State Fullerton days. And figured I'd bring it back since Luke actually coincidentally has this tune on his own album, so thought it would work out perfectly. This is an old Irving Berlin tune called Putting on the Ritz.
To go to, why don't you go where fashion sits? Putting on the Ritz. The different types who wear a day coat, pants with stripes, cutaway coat, perfect fits. Putting on the Ritz. Dressed up like a $1 million trooper, trying hard to look like Bradley Cooper. Super duper, come let's mix. Where Rockefellers walk with sticks or umbrellas in their mitts. Putting on the Ritz. Wilson. Jessica Ragsdale, trading with the band. You're blue and you don't know where to go to. Why don't you go where fashion sits? Putting on the Ritz. Different types are wearing a coat, pants with straps and cutaway coat. Perfect fits. Putting on the Ritz. Dressed up like a $1 million trooper. Trying hard to look like Bradley Cooper. Super duper, come let's mix. Where Rockefellers walk with sticks or umbrellas in their mitts. Putting on the Ritz. Putting on the Ritz. Putting on the Ritz. Nate
Nathan King, Brian Clemens, Nate Wilson, and Jessica Ragsdale on that one.
Luke Carlsen, everybody. Give it up for Luke. All right, this next tune is an instrumental. Take a break from vocal tunes for a bit. This is a tune that I wrote a couple months ago, and it is on the album as well, sort of in an Afro-Cuban style. And the story for this one is interesting. Sometimes I hear tunes in my sleep, and I kind of hear it while I'm partially waking up, you know, kind of the half sleep thing. And I know, but then that's the only way I could put songs on my album is if I don't, you know. So anyway, I kind of heard the beginning of this tune as I was waking up, and usually what happens is I take out my phone, I use the voice memo or the voice recording app, and I'm thinking, this is great, this is gonna be a great tune, I will be able to wake up, and I have it all, and I'll play it at a concert someday. And I go to the mic, and I record it, and I'm half asleep, and it ends up, I listen to it the next day, and it just sounds like, and so there's nothing to it. This time, however, it actually worked out. So this is called Call Out. Called Call Out. Thank you so much. Gotta love that Afro-Cuban stuff. Alrighty, what's next? Let's see. I'd like to bring up our next vocalist. I'm sure a lot of you guys know her. She's another Campus JAX veteran. Great person. I'm very, very thankful to have on my album, Miss Jamie Shew. Give it up for Jamie. This is an old Paul McCartney and Wings tune. We have any Paul McCartney fans out there? Cool, I hope so. He's my favorite Beatle. I know it's a common thing, but this is from one of his solo albums, a little bit more of an obscure album track called Heart of the Country. I've always been really into it and listening to it on road trips and whatnot, and one day I decided, hey, this would make a good jazz arrangement, so called up Jamie, wrote out this chart, and this is part of the country, so enjoy. Hope you guys are ready for more clarinet, too.
Always ready for more clarinet.
I look high, I look low, I'm looking everywhere I go, looking for a home in the heart of the country. I wanna move, I wanna go, I wanna tell everyone I know, I'm looking for a home in the heart of the country. Heart of the country where the holy people grow. Heart of the country, smell the grass in the meadow.
Jamie Shew, everybody. Give it up for Jamie. So happy to have her here. Give it up for the clarinet, to the instrument. It is great. And these players up here who play it so fantastic.
The mighty clarinet.
Of course, Nathan King.
Yeah.
Nate Wilson as well. We have two Nathans that actually play clarinet. What are the chances? Alrighty. So this tune, I still can't believe we're doing this tune. This is a tune I wrote back in high school that I decided to put on the album just because I wanted more original music and couldn't really think of anything else at the moment. So it's a tune I wrote back in high school, senior year, about a girl I had a crush on and never talked to. And so this was my only way to, you know, deal with that. And wrote the song, played it at a few open mics. Thank you. I appreciate all those two people that appreciate that. I don't think she's here. I don't think so. So she has no idea this is happening. Anyway, I was coming up with ideas for this album, and I thought of this, and I thought, you know what? This tune should come back. I only really played it at open mics to like two or three people, and same kind of clap you heard just a second ago, like the, you know, light, two people clapping. And but I thought, you know what, this could actually work as a big band tune. And so I put it together and, you know, had Jamie sing it, and there it is. So this is on the album as well. This is called If You Were Mine. Oh, yeah.
Brian Clemens, everyone.
Thank you.
We haven't recognized him just yet. This is his own tune. And all of his own arrangements. This is just an amazing night. So Brian Clemens, everybody.
Thank you, Teddy. Thank you. Just remember, I wrote this tune when I was 17, okay? So I'm 28 now. There's been a lot of time. I can write better songs now, I promise.
If you were mine, the world would be so fine, and you were mine, a sorrow wouldn't waste my time. I stand on my own, I would stay home, I'd never worry or whine. If you were mine, oh yeah, imagine what this world would be like if you were mine.
I would
chime if you were mine. So if you were mine, oh yeah. Imagine what this world would be like if you were mine.
Jamie Shew, everybody. Give it up for the band as well. Thank you so much. You guys having a good time so far? All righty. We are gonna move on with the show. I'd like to bring up our next vocalist for this tune, Sydney Cruz. Get up for Sydney. Any Billy Joel fans out there? Yeah? You might recognize this one. I believe we have a video coming up on the back too. Cool, just wanted to give it a sec for the video. All right.
To get away, take the holiday from the neighborhood, hop a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood, but I'm taking the Greyhound on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind. All the movie stars and the fancy cars and the limousines. Been high on the Rockies under the evergreens. But I know what I'm needing. I don't wanna waste more time. I'm in the New York state of mind. Touch with the rhythm and blues, but now I need a little give and take. The New York Times, the Daily News, comes back down to reality. Let it slide. Don't care if it's Chinatown or up in Riverside. Don't have any reasons, left them all behind. I'm in a New York state of mind. day. Out of touch with the rhythm and the hood. But now I need a little give and take. The New York Times, the Daily News. It comes down to I'm in the New York state of mind. Thank you so much.
Sydney Cruz, everybody. Give it up for Sydney. Got some pipes. And the city of New York. Give it up for the city of New York on that backdrop. The city of Newport Beach, of course, too, is great. You guys will hear again from Sydney a little bit later on. Let's see what's up next. All right, this is my solo part of the show, so you guys can all go to the bathroom if you want. So this is the first time I'm trying this out. This is a collection of tunes from West Side Story, which is one of my favorite movies, and been obsessed with Leonard Bernstein's genius score ever since I was a kid, and I watched that original film. I didn't like the new one quite as much, but I think it was still great, and I know, right? So this is actually an adaptation of a series of tunes from West Side Story called Symphonic Dances that Leonard Bernstein put together. Basically, it's some sort of instrumental medley of some music from the film. So I hope you guys enjoy. A lot of this is improvised, so honestly, I have no idea what's gonna happen. We'll find out.
Thank you.
We'll definitely do that again someday. That was the first time we ever did that. So, you know, it's a lot of fun. This is why I use an iPad, because these pages are always flying all over the place, you know? All right. What do we have next as the pages keep flying down? At least it's not raining this time, you know? It's just pages falling down, so. All right, let's move on to the next tune. We're going to bring back Jamie Shew, wherever she is. I'd also like to introduce another very, very special guest. I'm sure all of you guys know him, Mr. Tony Guerrero. Give it up for Tony. I was fortunate enough to have Tony on my album recording the solo for a tune, so of course, I was happy to see him here tonight, and he'll be playing on this one as well. So this is another tune, another original tune. I was over in Scotland in September, and just kind of going around the Highlands, and it was a really, really nice trip, really beautiful country. And I found this spot. I was sort of in this glen, which if you guys know, a glen is sort of like a valley in Scottish. And I'm not the type of person, well, not always, just to sort of sit somewhere for an hour and really just take it in. And this was an exception. It was one of the most beautiful spots I've barely ever seen. And so I sat there for an hour, basically until the bus was about to leave. And I thought, you know what? I should write a song about this. It's worth it. So I went back into the car and, you know, started to take out my text note app, whatever that is called. And then I got home and finished up this tune. So this is called A Scot in the Glen. A Scot in the Glen. It's not called A Scot in the Glen. It's called A Spot in the Glen. This is why I don't do the talkings at my gigs. Usually the singers do, for good reason. But this is called A Spot in the Glen, and hope you guys enjoy it. Promise there's not going to be any bagpipes, so don't worry. Here you go. You want to take the whole thing, or? Okay.
I can use mine, too, for you. There we go.
So we're going to start this off with the first aid section. First aid, and here's the bottom.
Come alive and beam into your sights. Then imagine one small place that could pull that all to waste. No matter how great those this grander where a withered heart is tranquil and free. It's empty, yet it's plenty, and it's in my reverie. A spot in the glen waiting for me. I'm here at last. I've let loose of my past, and now I feel I'm floating away. Now it seems it's like a perfect dream, a dream of which I'm fully awake. There's a soft and gentle wind and a hum that bends through the sun-brushed ends far as I see. I'm certain it's the curtain of every strife that be a spot in the glen. Hardships will end, a spot in the glen waiting for me. I'm here at last. I've let loose of my past, and now I feel I'm floating away. And now it seems it's like a perfect dream, a dream of which I'm fully aware. Sun-brushed ends, mountain to sea. I'm certain it's the curtain of every strife that be a spot in the glen. Hardships will end, a spot in the glen, place where I'll be. That simple spot in the glen, waiting for me.
Brian CLEMENS, everybody. That's a mighty pretty tune right there. Tony Guerrero on the flugelhorn.
Tony Guerrero, give it up for Tony and Jamie, guys. All right, I think we got a little bit of something back there. I don't know what note that is. The humming. So now for something completely different. I think this is as different as it gets. You guys see what I mean, right? Thank you. We all know what show that was from, right? Brought that into Jessica when we were doing a rehearsal. She looked at it and she laughed and she goes, oh, are you doing like a stand-up routine over this or something? And I said, no, we're actually, this is an arrangement I wrote and we're actually playing it, so. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Of course, that was a theme from Seinfeld, written in about 20 minutes by that original composer, I believe, Jonathan Wolf, so. Alrighty, let's bring up Anna Crumley again, ladies and gentlemen. Anna. I don't know if you guys can tell, there's not too much of a theme for this concert. It's sort of just like an eclectic mix of music I want to play. So it's kind of it, right? Here's something, another thing completely different. This is called Twilight Time, one of my favorite arrangements to write. It's a lot of fun. I actually wrote this originally back at CSUF and did it at my master's recital. If any of you guys were there, kind of revisited the chart. We have Anna on vocals now and looking forward to this one, so hope you enjoy it. It's called Twilight Time.
here at twilight time. I count the moments, darling, till you're here with me. Together, at last at twilight time. Here, in the afterglow of day, we'll keep our
Give it up for Anna once again. All right, now's the fun part of the night. No more sentimental stuff. We're having a party now. So Anna is gonna stay up here. We're gonna do a Stevie Wonder tune. I hope you guys know this one. Let's do it. Freddy Uyehara, everybody, on bass. Crumley, everybody, give it up for Anna. So happy to have her here tonight. Give it up for Nathan King, too, with that great solo. Freddy Uyehara with that great bass, pushing this tune all the way through. We're gonna reduce this to a trio just for a couple minutes, if you guys don't mind. Here's another Billy Joel tune. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's called Root Beer Rag. A lot of fun to play. All right, we are almost done with the show here. We just got about two more tunes, and let's bring up Sydney one more time. Sydney Cruz, everybody.
Let's see. I'm gonna readjust again.
Tonight is jazz night, but we're doing a bunch of different things. This is something you probably wouldn't hear on jazz night. This is actually a Rolling Stones tune. Hope you guys enjoy it. Later on, covered by Linda Ronstadt, of course.
Oh.
Cindy Cruz, everybody. What a great song. All righty, well, that brings us to our last and final song, of course. And, whoa, it's a small stage. All righty, so I'd just like to, of course, introduce this wonderful band. Let's start with the vocalists we've had tonight. So, of course, you just heard from Cindy Cruz, everybody. Let's give Cindy a hand. Right behind her, Anna Crumley. Is Luke Carlsen around here somewhere? I don't know, I'm sure he is. Here we go, Luke Carlsen. And of course, Jamie Shew. It takes a second to introduce this band as well. On drums, we got Jessica Ragsdale. On bass, Freddy Uyehara. Guitar, Zachary Caplinger. Hope you guys can see him back there. On trumpet, we got Ian Holmquist. Yeah, Ian. Second trumpet, Tim Mathiesen. Trombone, Andrew Munoz. Elijah Parra, trombone number two. Woodwinds, of course, we got Nathan King. The wonderful Stephen Ragsdale. Nick Gomez, tenor saxophone, clarinet. He just came out with an album as well, so check that out, Nick Gomez. And then on baritone, we got Nate Wilson. There's two Nathans. I almost said the other Nathan's last name. Nate Wilson, he's got the best hair in the band. We all voted, so. Of course, we'd like to thank, Tom Zink is here. He was the engineer on the album, and he worked with me, so definitely one of the most patient men out there, that's for sure. One of the nicest pianos I've ever played, too. So Tom Zink, let's give Tom Zink a hand. He did a fantastic job. All right, and of course, thank you to Campus JAX for making this happen. What a great place. We love it.
Once there was a way to get back homeward. Once there was a way to get back home. Sleep, little darling, do not cry. And I will sing a lullaby. Get back homeward. Once there was a way to get back home. Sleep, little darling, do not cry. And I will sing a lullaby. Thank you.
Everybody. Thank you so much, everybody. This microphone desperately wants to get away from me.
Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you.
Brian Clemens and the band and the vocalists and Campus JAX. And if you'll just stick around, we have a little timeshare presentation. We just want to remind you again, take six next Thursday. Elena Gilliam this coming Sunday, Jason Favis shortly after that, me sometime later, a bunch of other people throughout the next few weeks. So keep supporting live jazz and